for one fall. Introducing first the team to my right, first from the University of Oklahoma. He weighs 268 pounds. Chief Wahoo McDaniels. His partner hails from Mound, Minnesota. He is the AWA International Television Champion at 218 pounds. Greg Gagne. And now, ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, first from Kansas City. He weighs in at 256 pounds, the ace cowboy, Bob Orton. And his partner from Robbinsdale, Minnesota. He weighs at 256 pounds. He is the AWA World Heavyweight Champion, Cool Curt Hennig.
Couple of outstanding tag team combinations here. It's not for the championship of the world, but hey, someday it well could be, as either one of these tag teams are indeed worthy challengers to the champions, and the champions, of course, being the Midnight Rockers, Marty Jannetty and Shawn Michaels. Here is Wahoo McDaniel against Ace Bob Orton, and Ace Bob Orton going to work with forearms and elbows. And now it is Wahoo reversing on the ace and catching him coming off with a judo shot. And Ace Bob Orton is not going to be able to have the quick, fast start here against the likes of a Wahoo McDaniel that he likes to get in many of his matches. But very quickly, he tags in the heavyweight champion of the world, Curt Hennig, and suddenly it is Hennig. Wahoo McDaniel going to work on him. And back with me again, Lee Marshall out of Los Angeles, California. And Lee, this indeed should be one of the great tag team matches, although it's not for the championship of the world that we've seen in a long, long time.
Rod, every fan has got to love a match like this. The ace Bob Orton, Cool Curt Hennig, the champion of the world, Wahoo McDaniels, and Greg Gagne. And in trying to do a little math, I wonder if you could help me out. If you could figure out between the four men that are in the ring, or two of them outside of it right now, how many titles they have all held collectively over their careers. You are seeing some history in the ring today.
A lot of talent, a lot of explosive power from each and every one of the four involved in this one.
Just look at them. It just does not get any better than this, Rod.
Here's a side headlock by Wahoo McDaniel. And here is Greg Gagne. Oh. Greg Gagne and Curt Hennig. And that feud has gone on for a long, long time. And it started in actuality while these two were still very young men before they ever put on a pair of wrestling tights and got into the squared ring. And of course, it was started by their fathers, Larry the Axe Hennig and Vern Gagne, and it carries over from father to son. And the war, the feud, it continues to exist.
Did you see that shot that Hennig got right into Gagne's kidney?
Yeah.
Look at the reversal on the hip lock by Gagne. Another hip toss by Gagne.
And it looks like Greg got a thumb or a shot in the eye. Whatever. Here is Ace Bob Orton being tagged in. Look at this. A rollover. Oliver Orton is able to kick him off, but Gagne comes right back with an arm drag takedown and tags in Wahoo McDaniel. That full-blooded Choctaw Chickasaw Indian out of the University of Oklahoma, the former professional football star, an excellent, excellent golfer with a scratch handicap. And would you believe he'll run a 40 in 4.6.
No kidding.
Wow. He can do it all. Wahoo McDaniel. And Orton, while flat on his back, is able to tag in Curt Hennig. And I don't think Wahoo McDaniel saw that or expected that tag.
No, he sure didn't. And again, you say what you like about Bob Orton, or say what you dislike about Bob Orton. I'm sure the list is much longer that way. But the man is a technician, Rod. He knows what he's doing every second in that squared circle.
Front face lock here by the champion.
Look at him just put the weight on Wahoo. He's making Wahoo carry that weight around, trying to wear him down.
Great knowledge and awareness of body balance. They all have it. And on display there, there's a nice reversal and into a hammerlock by Wahoo McDaniel. A bridge here by the champion, Curt Hennig, as McDaniel really has him tied up. And again, Ledoux goes into a count. And again, Hennig is forced to bridge. And only the tremendous conditioning, tremendous neck muscles, has kept Hennig from defeat here in this situation that Wahoo McDaniel has him in.
That's true, Rod. You know, you go into any gym, any bodybuilder gym, and you'll find the professional wrestlers working out there. And one of the things that they work on every day is their neck muscles. Every day. You can't be a professional wrestler without a very strong neck.
Take it from a man who works out daily at Gold's Gymnasium in Venice Beach, California.
That nice being reversal. Nice yes. reversal. Like that. Yeah, we're going to get you out there and move some iron around, Rod.
Yeah, I'm ready. I'm ready.
Well, there's a Gold's in right near Minneapolis. My friend John Mann has the Gold's there. You're more than welcome.
Look forward to it, and not so welcome. Certainly no thank you from Wahoo McDaniel as Ace Orton now applies the atomic drop, and Wahoo McDaniel returns the favor. And from the outside, Greg Gagne pounds away, and now he is tagged in. And now the whip. And just when it looked like he was going to really connect with a drop kick on Ace Bob Orton, Orton grabs a hold of that rope, comes off with a knee drop on Greg Gagne, picks him up, holds him over his head
with one arm,
and a backbreaker. And now tagging in Curt Hennig, who loves the situation that he finds Greg Gagne in.
3 minutes left.
And here's a backbreaker of his own. Hennig on Gagne, not once, but twice.
Oh.
Covers, hooks the leg. Gets a count of two.
I don't know how he kicked out of that. His back has got to be so weak from the punishment dished out by Hennig and Orton. Look at him fire back, though.
They exchange blows in the center of the ring. First Gagne, then Hennig, and now a cover by Gagne. It is Ace Bob Orton coming in from the outside that saved that tag team from defeat right then and there. And now it is Orton back in, following the tag from Hennig. And Greg Gagne needs some help.
Oh.
A boot to the forehead of Greg Gagne. Stunned. Still on his feet, however, and still in there, and still aware. Ducks under a roundhouse right, but Orton muscles and powers him over into the corner and delivers a shoulder block right into the solar plexus. As we have 2 minutes remaining,
Gagne
here from the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada. Indeed, he is doing that very, very thing. And here is a sleeper hold. Wahoo McDaniel comes over, but he can't get to Orton before Orton is able to get to Gagne and break that sleeper hold. Now it is Gagne bouncing the head of Hennig off the ropes, but here's a reversal by Orton and Hennig. And the collision is Wahoo and Greg Gagne.
That's got to be all. Hey, yeah, that's got to be all.
It is. It's all over. As Greg Gagne is thrown over that top rope and intentionally so by Ace Bob Orton, who continues his attack on Wahoo McDaniel. Picks up McDaniel and now going to give him a pile driver, and he does. As the bell rings, but to actually Bob Orton pays little or any attention to the bell and continues his assault inside the ring as the fight goes on outside of the ring between Greg Gagne and Curt Hennig.
I got to believe that Gagne and Hennig are just going to go at each other until somebody can break them up. If they can't get it taken care of in the ring, they're going to continue to do it outside of the ring. I mean, these two guys just flat out do not like each other, Rod.
Orton now outside of the ring, but Greg Gagne sensing that and isn't going to get into a two-against-one situation with the likes of Hennig and Orton outside of the ring, quickly gets back in and goes to the aid of his tag team partner, Wahoo McDaniel, who has taken a heck of a pounding from Ace Bob Orton. And there's the collision as you see it in the ring. The reversal by Hennig and Orton, and the collision of Gagne, and up and over and out goes Gagne. The collision between Gagne and Wahoo McDaniel, and then the subsequent disqualification as Greg was tossed over that top rope by Ace Bob Orton. We're at the Showboat. We'll be right back.